Good morning. And happy Easter. Let's welcome each other's return to the people around us, sharing with them the Easter joy and the light of Christ, risen Lord, in our hearts. And now we take a moment to also lift up to the Lord the intentions and petitions we have, praying for one another, remembering to pray for peace in the world, the end of violence of all kind against humanity, especially the unborn, remembering as well to pray for the poor, families that struggle, and victims of tragedies and calamities. Today, on the second day of the octave of Easter, our entrance song is Table of Plenty.
To the feast of heaven and earth, come to the table of plenty. God will provide for all that we need. Here at the table of plenty. Oh, come and sit at my table, where saints and sinners are friends. I wait to welcome the lost and lowly to share the cup of my love. Come to the feast of heaven and earth. Come to the table of plenty. God will provide for all that we need. Here at the table of plenty.
In the name of the Father, and Son, of the Holy Spirit, amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Gathered to celebrate the sacred mysteries, we humble ourselves to a loving and compassionate God as we pray.
You raise us to new life, Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
You forgive our sins, Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
You feed us with your body and your blood, Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. Glory
to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen, amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill.
Let us pray. O God, who have bestowed on us paschal remedies, endow your people with heavenly gifts, so that possessed of perfect wisdom, they may rejoice in heaven over what gladdens them now on earth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. On the day of Pentecost, Peter said to the Jewish people, "Let the whole house of Israel know for certain that God has made him both Lord and Christ, this Jesus whom you crucified." Now when they heard this, they were cut to the heart. And they asked Peter and the other apostles, "What are we to do, my brothers?" Peter said to them, "Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the forgiveness of your sins, and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. For the promise is made to you and to your children and to all those far off, whomever the Lord our God will call. He has testified with many arguments and was exhorting them, 'Save yourselves from this corrupt generation.' Those who accepted his message were baptized. About 3,000 persons were added that day." The word of the Lord. Be to God. The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord. The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord. Upright is the word of the Lord, and all his works are trustworthy. He loves justice and right. Of kindness, the Lord, the earth is full. The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord. See, the eyes of the Lord are upon those who fear him, upon those who hope for his kindness, to deliver them from death, to preserve them in spite of famine. The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord. Our soul waits for the Lord, who is our help and our shield. May your kindness, O Lord, be upon us, who have put our hope in you. The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Mary Magdalene stayed outside the tomb weeping. And as she wept, she bent over the tomb and saw two angels in white sitting there, one at the head and one at the feet, where the body of Jesus had been. And they said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them, "They have taken my Lord, and I don't know where they laid him." When she had said this, she turned around and saw Jesus there, but did not know it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you looking for?" She thought it was the gardener and said to him, "Sir, if you carried him away, tell me where you laid him, and I will take him." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him in Hebrew, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Stop holding on to me, for I have not yet ascended to the Father. But go to my brothers and tell them, I am going to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God." Mary went and announced to the disciples, "I have seen the Lord," and then reported what he had told her. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
It was the summer of 1971. I lived up in Northern California, and so I was a huge San Francisco Giants baseball fan, to the point of obsession, because that was the year they ended up winning the pennant by one game. Well, we went to Mass up in the mountains near where our cabin is, and after Mass, there was a parish picnic, and my parents decided to stay at the picnic. So I was, being a bored 11-year-old, decided that it'd be much better to go to my dad's car and listen to the Giants game. Well, a man walked up to me and said, "May I sit in the car next to you and listen to the game?" And I said, "Sure." So for about 10 minutes, we're talking baseball. We knew much more than the manager of the Giants at that time, Charlie Fox, you know, and we were just going back and forth. This man was extremely knowledgeable about baseball. But our time together was interrupted when a bunch of people from the picnic came out and came up to our car and said to him, "We've been looking all over for you, Bishop." You see, the person who had chosen to sit in the car with me was none other than the Bishop of Stockton, the honored guest of the picnic. And yet, I didn't recognize him. I was so focused on baseball, I didn't even know the bishop had gotten into the car with me and was talking baseball. And then I look at him again, and then suddenly I notice he's wearing his cleric. I was an altar server at the Mass he had just served at, but yet I didn't notice because my own focus was on the Giants and the pennant. Many of the resurrection stories, we have a similar theme. We have the same thing going on where people don't notice who Jesus is, as we heard in today's gospel. We hear, like we heard with Mary Magdalene, not being able to recognize who Jesus was. And yes, of course his appearance probably was different, but she had already not expected it. She had seen Jesus die. There is no way that could be Jesus. And she would look at him and say, "Well, it must be a gardener." Similar in many of the resurrection stories, there's a moment where suddenly eyes are open. People recognize just who Jesus is. And that moment, all of a sudden, whatever they were focused on becomes much more important. For Mary Magdalene, suddenly about finding ways to find the body of Jesus to prepare him for burial becomes so much less important. For an 11-year-old boy talking about baseball, suddenly I was like overwhelmed that I didn't notice the bishop sitting in my car. As I was reflecting on this homily yesterday at lunch, I went for a walk in the sports park by my office. And I was actually saying, no one's gonna believe that an 11-year-old would be that oblivious. And lo and behold, I walked by a group of kids about 11. They were playing, I think they had a birthday party going on, and all of a sudden one little girl runs up to me and she goes, do I know you? So I asked her, I said, well, where do you go to church? She goes, oh, you wear those funny clothes and sitting next to the priest. And I go, yeah. Oh, that's who you are. And then she went off and played with her friends before I can ask her her name. How many times in life have we done the same thing? Not recognize Jesus in our presence. Because we only expect maybe to see Jesus one way. Maybe we only expect him and we don't see Jesus in the people around us who are present, that God is present in them, as we've heard like in Matthew 25. How many people do we ignore and not recognize the presence of the risen Lord? In the psalm we just proclaimed, we said the earth is full of God's goodness. May we open up ourselves to recognize the goodness of God. 3,000 people in our first reading were willing to set aside their preconceived notions about who Jesus was to recognize him. And then, led by the Holy Spirit, Peter was able to baptize him this morning. May we recognize Jesus in all the events of our lives.
The Lord has delivered us from the ignominy of sin. May we share in the triumph of his resurrection by repenting of our sins and turning to God with hope and trust.
Our response, risen Lord, we have put our hope in you.
Risen Lord, we put our hope in you.
Risen Lord, bring to mind the cry of Mary, I have seen the Lord, and grant us faith to believe. Let us pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, we put our hope in you.
May Mary Magdalene, the first to witness Christ's resurrection and a true and authentic evangelizer, be an inspiration to all Christians to reflect more deeply the dignity of women, the new evangelization, and the greatness of the mystery of divine mercy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, we put our hope in you.
May the tears of Mary Magdalene at the tomb be a reminder of all that sometimes in our lives, tears are the lenses we need to see Jesus. Let us pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, we put our hope in you.
Lord of life, bring your word of life to those enslaved by fear, those in need of comfort, and those walking in darkness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, we put our hope in you.
In your resurrection, heaven is welded to earth and all creation is reconciled with God. Watch over humanity and creation still in agony and waiting for the revelation of the children of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, we put our hope in you. We lift up to the Lord in the silence of our hearts the intentions and petitions we have for our families and our loved ones. We pray for the intentions for whom this Mass is offered, for Ophelia Burgos and Armando Maldonado, and the eternal repose of the soul of Nora Sanchez, we pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord,
we put our hope in you. For the intentions submitted to us, for Isabella Abuan, for Ike Cowit, for Ricardo Tejano, we pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord,
we put our hope in you. For those in need of strength, healing, and comfort, Lorenzo Moran, Imelda Martin, Evelyn Ding Lasan, Nancy Wetmore, Lita Casillas, Anthony Nguyen, and Brittany Rosales, we pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, we put our hope in you.
And for our dearly departed, Milt Tennant, Ray Callahan, Mercedes St. Hilaire, Angel Sarosa, Sione de la Cruz, and Belen Teano, we pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, we put our hope in you.
Loving Father, we give you thanks for the marvelous things you have done in Christ. Grant us to die daily to sin and live with him in the joy of the resurrection. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Accept in compassion, Lord, we pray, the offerings of your family, that under your protective care they may never lose what they have received, but attain the gifts that are eternal. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you, let more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You're indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts you have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, Santiago de Compostela, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, your servant Francis, our Pope, Kevin, our Bishop, Timothy and Thomas, his brother bishops, the order of bishops, all the priests, deacons, religious, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. Your compassionate and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. 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 At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. For those unable to receive our Lord Jesus sacramentally, please take a moment for the prayer for spiritual communion. Body of Christ.
One Lord of all,
Let us pray. Hear us, Almighty God, and as you have bestowed on your family the perfect grace of baptism, so prepare their hearts for the reward of eternal happiness through Christ our Lord. Pray to our loving Mother, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And to Saint Joseph, Hail Guardian of the Redeemer, Spouse of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to you God entrusted his only Son. In you Mary place her trust. With you Christ was secure and safe. Blessed Joseph, to us too show yourself a Father and guide us to the path of life. Obtain for us grace, mercy, and courage, and defend us from every evil. Amen. Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. And may God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless all of you and your loved ones, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Go in peace. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Happy Easter.
Hail, Holy Queen, enthroned above, O Maria. Hail, Mother of mercy and of love, O Maria. Triumphal in cherubim, sing with us, ye seraphim. Heaven and earth resound the hymn, Salve, Salve, Salve Regina.
Our life, our sweetness here below, O Maria. Our hope in sorrow and in woe, O Maria. Triumphal in cherubim, sing with us, ye seraphim. Heaven and earth resound the hymn, Salve, Salve, Salve Regina.
Have a blessed day, everyone. Happy Easter.